Welcome all. In this lecture, we are going to learn about DC servo motors. So in the earlier lecture, we discussed that there are two types of servo motors, that is AC servo motor and DC servo motor. So firstly, let's discuss about DC servo motor. A DC servo motor behaves like a mechanical transducer. So what the mechanical transducer basically do? So the mechanical transducer converts the DC voltage in the mechanical energy. Since the DC servo motor behaves like a mechanical transducer, that's why it converts the DC voltage in the mechanical energy. There are basically two types of DC servo motor, that is armature control DC servo motor and field control DC servo motor. There are some differences in between these two, armature control and field control DC servo motor. Let's understand the armature control servo motor. So in the armature control DC servo motor, the field is held constant and the armature current have a responsibility that varies to control the torque. So since it is an armature control, that's why the torque is being controlled by varying the armature current. Let's move on to the field control DC servo motor. In the field control DC servo motor, the armature current is held constant, but the field current varies to control the torque. So in the field control servo motor, the torque is being controlled by the help of variation in the field. That's why it is named as field controlled DC servo motor. Now let us have a look at the diagram of DC servo motor. So the DC servo motor are generally called separately excited DC servo motor. Why it is called separately excited? Because in this circuit, both the rotor, that is this section, and the stator, that is this part, are separately excited by the external DC voltages. This is the rotor circuit and this is stator circuit. And in the rotor circuit, the input are DC voltages applied, and at the input of this stator circuit, we have also applied the separate DC voltage. Since both the DC voltage are being separated from each other, that's why we can also say that the DC servo motors are separately excited DC servo motor. Now it is considered that the armature controlled DC servo motor is quite better than the field controlled servo motor, because the armature controlled servo motor have a fast response. The speed of the response of the armature controlled servo motor is fast. That's why we have to prefer armature controlled servo motor in place of field controlled servo motor. There are some applications which are associated with armature controlled servo motor. So the armature controlled servo motor is used in the radars. It is also used in computer application and the designing of hardware. Armature control servo motor is used in developing robots. Since it has servo motor works on the mechanism of servo mechanism, that's why it is used in electrical appliances also. So these all are the applications that are associated with armature controlled servo motor. Now let's have a discuss about the armature control servo motor and field control servo motor. So here is a difference between both these functionalities. So in case of armature controlled servo motor, the performance is better. Why? Because it has a closed loop. Since in the closed loop, there is a feedback loop that is introduced, which will improve the performance of a system. That's why we can consider that the armature controlled servo motor have better performance. But in case of field controlled servo motor, the performance is poor because of open loop. As there is no feedback loop, that's why the performance is poor. Moving on to next point, that is inductance of the armature circuit is negligible. But on the other hand, the inductance offered by the field circuit is not negligible. As we discussed that the armature controlled servo motor is quite better than field controlled servo motor because of the fast response. So this is also mentioned in the third point, that is the speed of the response to changing current is fast in case of armature controlled servo motor. But the speed of response to changing current is slow in case of field control servo motor. So this is all about the armature control servo motor and field control servo motor. In this lecture, we learn about the basic introduction about the DC servo motor. Thank you.